It was a cold Christmas day, 1864, in the Longfellow house. And the chill was not just because of the winter winds that howled outside, but because the hearts of a father and his children were cold as ice. Frances, their wife and mother, was gone, dead from burns sustained in a fire.
A faint song of hope began to ring in his heart, and the message of peace began to flow from his pen.